terrible. But anyways, that was my little intro attempt. Not that good. Don't mind me, I'm not a great player, just a fan having fun. But anyways, so what's up everyone? This is Bath3177 here, and today is the 27th of February. So I'm doing this very late, but I'm still gonna do it anyways. So basically, a little bit more than 3 weeks ago on, I think it was the 2nd of February, I think it was, yeah. So I went to Kansas City. So I'm from Singapore, you know, for those who don't know. So I went to Kansas City to catch the Disturbed Take Back Your Life tour. So, you know, Disturbed has been one of my favorite bands growing up. One of the bands that basically got me through all the tough times and all that, you know, when I'm alone, when I'm feeling sad, depressed, or whatever, even when I'm happy or whatever, you know, basically every part of my childhood, Disturbed was one of the bands that was with me the whole time. So I never got to see them live, so I thought, hey, this time it was a great opportunity, and I did it. So I did the VIP experience, the VIP package, just like what I did last year in Knotfest Australia and Knotfest Japan. And my original plan was to vlog it like I did last year for Australia and Japan, the Knotfest Australia and Japan, you know, basically to show everybody, you know, what it's like, you know, when you get the VIP package, what happens, you know, I did this Knotfest Japan. There's an entire episode of my Knotfest Japan vlog where it's just like the VIP experience, where the whole video is just basically me, you know, filming the entire VIP experience. So I wanted to do something like that for this, to show everybody, you know, like what it's like to get a VIP experience, to get the VIP package for Disturbed's tour. But unfortunately, we're not allowed to take pictures or videos. Like the guy before the whole VIP tour, actually, when he was giving like the briefing, he was saying like, there are things that you're allowed to take pictures of, and there are things that you're not allowed to take pictures of. But he wouldn't tell us which, you know? So he's just like, you're gonna know when you see it. I'm not gonna tell you. And if I see you take pictures of something that you don't, that is not allowed, I'll come to you and I'll tell you to delete it and all that, you know? So, you know, basically we don't know what we're allowed to take and not allowed to take. So, you know, I didn't wanna risk any getting into trouble. I didn't want to get my ass kicked out of the arena. So I didn't take anything, any videos or pictures. I did take a selfie on the stage when we were standing on the stage though. And other than that, the only thing that I have from the VIP experience is basically the VIP package, which I'll show you guys later. And the picture of the band and the group picture on the stage that the staff took for us. So basically, you do get to meet the band, you do get to have a picture of the band, but it's taken by one of their staff members, and then they'll send it to you via Dropbox, I think it's called. So yeah, you know, so you can't even use your own phones, you know, to take the pictures and all that. But yeah, so because I'm not able to take footage and, you know, do the whole full vlog like I did for Knotfest Japan and Australia, I decided to do this, you know, little, like, just me sitting here on my bed, to tell you guys about my experience. And then later on in the video, there will be some footage of, like, the show, and, I believe I took videos of like outside the arena, you know, before and after the show. But yeah, there will be footage of like the shows from all three bands that performed. And yeah, so before all that, I just want to tell you guys basically what happened, what was the whole like VIP experience or whatever. So basically, okay, the show was on the 2nd of February, okay? And as usual, me being me, I cut it real close. I love living on the edge. So I actually flew in from Boston to Kansas City on the day itself. I was in Boston before that. I'm from Singapore, by the way. I think I already said that. But So I went from Singapore to Boston, caught some Celtics games, and then I flew from Boston to Kansas City for the show. Okay, so on the day of the show, I took a flight from Boston in the morning at about, I like to say 9 or 10, can't remember, I think maybe 10. And I landed in Kansas City at 12. Okay, and we were, the VIP ticket holders were told to report at T-Mobile Center at 4. Okay, we had to be there by 4. Okay, so I was really cutting it real close. Like, I couldn't afford any flight delays or flight cancellations or whatever. If I did, I'm pretty much done. I'll probably have missed the show, or at least miss my VIP stuff. You know, like if they delayed it or whatever, I might still be able to make the show. But you know, I paid all that money for the VIP experience, so definitely, obviously, I didn't want to miss that, right? So, there was no delays. The flight took off on time, landed on time. It was a very pleasant flight. I got to meet this lady and her kid sitting beside me. You know, I was just talking to them, playing the kid a little bit here and there. Flight went by real fast. Real cool flight. I landed at about, I'll say maybe 12. And then I took an Uber to my hotel. And that Uber was so hard to find a hotel because I didn't know, like, where I'm supposed to put my pickup point. And then the Uber guy arrived at another part of the, you know, the pickup area, and I had no idea where he was. It took me like 10 minutes to find him, but eventually I found him, got to my hotel. It was like it was only like a 10 minute drive from the airport to my hotel. So I got there, checked in, ordered some Uber Eats, had a quick little lunch, rested a little bit, and had a shower, and then took an Uber to T-Mobile Center. Just walked around the area a little bit. I saw like the college basketball, I think it was a museum, I can't remember, but I saw like the college basketball or whatever. Wanted to go there, but I was in a rush. So by about 3:30 or 3:45 around there, I was already at the line, waiting to get in, and there was already a bunch of people there before me, so they were early. The weather was great. You know, like, I came from Boston, which was freezing cold, but when I went there to Kansas City, it was just cooling. You know, I didn't need like the winter jackets. I just needed one hoodie, so it was pretty good. So we went in, we checked in, we got our VIP little pack. So what we got is obviously this lanyard, you know, this VIP lanyard, very cool, love it. And then they give us a deck of playing cards and this little bag. Okay, so after that, I believe he was the tour manager, I don't know, the guy that's in charge of all this came out and gave us the briefing. That's where, like I said earlier, told us like, oh, you're not allowed to take videos, pictures, or whatever. So he gave us a briefing, and then he took us down to basically the venue, the arena, you know, like the, what do you call that? Basically just took us in. So we went in, he took us to the sound area, you know, where all the magic happens, and just showed us there. And then he took us onto the stage. So we got to go on stage, and we saw some of the equipment and all that. I took like a little selfie, I'll post it later on the stage. I think in my background I had like plush LTD guitars in the background, so it was pretty cool. And then we took a group picture on stage, which again I'll put later in the video. We took a group picture on stage, and then they took us backstage, and we got to see some other stuff. And they were basically explaining it to us, like, before every show, what happens, like how they load stuff in, you know, bringing in all the petrol for the pyro and all that. We got to see, not inside, but you know, outside, some of the like the resting rooms, where the catering is and whatever. And then finally we went to a room, and Disturbed was in there. So that's where we got to take our pictures. So it wasn't like we got to, you know, we didn't really get much time with them, which I get, you know, because there's so many people and there's time constraints. You know, they're not going to let everybody have like 10 minutes to talk to them. That's going to take forever, right? I do wish that I would have get the chance to talk to them a little bit more. But again, like I said, you know, I get it. So went in there, fist bump like all four members, just said what's up, hey, whatever. And then I got to tell Dan Donegan how much of a big fan I was and how I got like two of his guitars, one of them right here. And he was like, oh, that's cool. And then took our pictures and got out of there. And then the lady, you know, there was a lady standing outside waiting for everyone after taking their pictures. After they walk out, they gave everyone one of these signed vinyls. So we were not allowed to bring anything for them to get signed. They were not doing signings there. They were not going to sign. They were just taking pictures. So you're not allowed to bring anything to get signed because they're already going to give you something that's already signed. So it's a really cool thing. You know, I don't have a vinyl. I have a lot of CDs, but I don't have any vinyls. So this is, you know, one of my only, I think I do have like a couple of Linkin Park vinyls, but other than that, this is like one of my few vinyls. And it's really cool. It, you know, I've always liked the Divisive cover, and all four members signed it with this silver paint pen, and it looks really good. I really love it. So I'm gonna think of what to do with it. I might frame it or whatever, but yeah, so this is what they gave us. So after that, it was basically free and easy. You could do whatever you want before the show. I went to the pit area, just stood there and waited. And then I was scrolling on IG and I saw that they hit like a signed drum hit like somewhere in the arena. And I actually figured out where it was and I went there. But when I went there, literally when I was walking there, I saw like two girls go there and they found the item like right before me. So I was like 2 seconds late. And then I was like, oh, well. And then like the Disturbed social media lady, I think she might be a different role. I don't know. But I think she was the social media lady. So she saw me and, you know, she was like, oh, you were 2 seconds late. Sorry about that. And I'm like, that's all good. You know, I was like, I came all the way here from Singapore. I got to see, I get to see my favorite band later. You know, I'm like, I'm cool. And then she's like, oh, can I interview you? So I was like, sure. So she did like a short little interview asking me what Disturbed meant to me. My bad. So like what Disturbed meant to me and what are the songs that I would like to hear live. So, well, I didn't have a really particularly interesting answer. I just said something like along the lines of, oh, you know, I came all the way here from Singapore. So obviously they mean a lot to me. And then something like, what I say? I said something along the lines of, they're one of the bands that I grew up with. There are a few bands that I listened to growing up, and Disturbed is definitely one of the top, you know, like somewhere like up there. So something like that. So it was pretty cool. You know, I felt like a VIP. You know, I mean, hey, I got the VIP, right? So after that, went back to the pits, and Plush started playing, and I would like to say, like, it was my first time listening to Plush. Like, I've never heard of Plush in my entire life before that. And that was my first time, and they were so good. Like, I fell in love immediately. And then after Plush, Falling in Reverse started playing. I know Falling in Reverse. I do like some of their songs. And they were so good. Like, the stage presence, like, it was crazy. Like they set the whole place on fire. Like, you know, it was crazy. Like, they were so good live. Like, really. And then finally, Disturbed played. And yeah, it was a great show. A lot of pyro, like they said. You could feel the heat where I was standing. I was at the pit area, so I was pretty front. There was a mosh pit happening on my right side. In the front, there was like fire blasting out. It was a crazy experience. So I really enjoyed it. So yeah, you know, this is basically what happened. Man, it's already almost 16 minutes. That's so long already. So I'm gonna leave it here. I'm gonna stop talking. It's too long. 15 minutes is too long. So I'm gonna end it right here. And for the rest of the video, it's just gonna be footage of, you know, it's basically gonna be the vlog of this vlog. You know, like, this is obviously, this talking is not the vlog. So I'm gonna put like the footage from my day. There's gonna be like videos of, you know, like outside the arena before and after the show. Nobody really needs to see that, but I'm gonna put that in anyways. And then we got footage from the show from all three members, from all three bands. So there'll be footage of Plush, there'll be footage of Falling Reverse, and obviously Disturbed. I have every song of Disturbed, so I'm gonna put like, you know, like a little bit of each song in there. I'm gonna end it right here. Enjoy the rest of the video. Peace. All right, I'm at Kansas City right now. About to head to my hotel room. I just checked in, so now I'm gonna go into my room for the first time. It was like a 3 hours flight, so it's not too bad. Can't wait to go to the concert today. Disturbed. So this is my room, 518. There you go. Here it is. This is a really dope room. Let me just throw my stuff here real quick. Here's the bathroom. Where's the light? Is this? There you go.
I got people that don't like me in the industry. I can feel your energy. You were not a friend to me. Cause I have been to places that you never wanna go. I got dirt on people, but they act like I don't know. I can do some damage, but I'll never find the fault. My intent is what I'm supposed to do.
I'm not afraid to Thank you. anxiety for the last 6 years of my life. On January 3rd, 2023, I tried to take my life. Your music has helped me more than you'll ever know over the years, and especially here recently. And I just wanted to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. Did you want to say anything to anybody? You don't have to. I think your sign said enough.
I just want to let you all know, it's been a hard ride. It really has.
Keep kicking ass, baby!
I struggle with it every single day. You know, it sits in the back of my head. But over the last year, I've battled it. It's been hard. It hasn't been easy.
Keep going! Keep going!
It's all right, brother. It's okay. You know something? We've got you. Okay? You have a seat. Join us for the next song, okay? Give me a birthday boy. That's it. It's his 16th birthday present. What's your name, brother?
Corbin.
Everybody say hello to Corbin. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Why don't you join us for the next song as well? Have a seat.
Come on, hang on a second.
I never get tired of it. Ever. You know, I think it's funny, and I can't help but mention it. I'm probably gonna get in a little bit of trouble for this, and I know everybody backstage is going, oh my God, what is he going to say? But it was brought to my attention that a contingent from the Westboro Baptist Church came here to protest the show tonight.
Because they think this is just devil music.
What an absolute load of unbelievably stinking, festering horse shit that is. Let me ask you something. Do you see any sin up here? Possibly be bad about setting people free every single night. You know what's a sin? Vanity is a sin, motherfuckers. And for them to be so vain as to look down from their high horse and look at all of us and tell us that we're doing something wrong, who's the sinner? What's the worst thing you're gonna experience at a Disturbed show? A little bit of profanity? Will profanity kill you? No, but the darkness can. And it is our job to dispel the darkness. end point. Besides, you know, I have a soft spot for this gentleman, not only because of what he's gone through, but because we've all gone through it ourselves. And Gabriel, I have a secret for you. Sometimes darkness can show you the light.
Thank you. Just another lost soul.